Philip Taylor, you get a chance to go to the movies on us. And I'm telling you, this is a movie theater. The reclining seats and all of the good things. Oh, you know what? There's one downside, though. All the movie theaters use microwave ovens. And we have to talk about that right now with Dave Sandoval. Dave, listen, in the short period of time that we have right now, what's wrong with this appliance? Is it the radiation?
You know, it's just an outdated thing. Honestly, there's so many better things that you could use. The microwave has dangers. If you stand too close, there's radiation. They're trying to fix that, but older machines still have that problem. If you pop popcorn in a microwave, it's proven to be toxic to children, to their lungs. You know, you don't want children around microwaved popcorn.
Why? What's toxic about the popcorn in the microwave?
The oil, when it cooks, creates a fume, and then you breathe it, and you're actually inhaling toxic fumes just from that delicious smell from microwave popcorn.
Okay, if you're going to pass out popcorn at Halloween, trick or treat, then you don't have any problems at all as long as you don't microwave it. No problems,
right.
No problems this Halloween with any of the treats. Is that what you're saying, David?
Actually, if you're a mother or a father, you've really got to be careful. Halloween is a big red flag danger zone as a parent. And it doesn't have to be that way. There's actually logical solutions when your children want snacks. And so I've put together here good snack, bad snack,
okay,
if that's okay.
Where's the good one?
Well, we got to start with ingredients. Everything you eat is simply ingredients. Now, a typical Oreo cookie is going to have hydrogenated oils, trans fats, high fructose corn syrup, artificial colors, and artificial flavors. Here's a cookie, looks just the same, tastes almost identical, yet if you see here, the manufacturer is responsible, and they're making this something that a mother would be willing to give their children.
So look at the ingredients.
Look at the ingredients. Now, check this out. You've got one, you know, you're going up trick-or-treat.
Right.
You've got this red licorice, red dye number 40, proven to be very, very bad for you.
High fructose
corn syrup, proven to be very bad for you.
I'm in the office all the time.
Now look at the black licorice.
Yeah.
This is flavored with anise, which is a natural herb that helps with digestion. And so you look at the combination, this looks a lot like this. The only difference is fake sugar, fake color, real sugar, real color. They both taste great.
Well, I'll tell you what, why don't I just get a couple of candy bars then?
Well, here's the problem. See this little snack, this one little snack, this is 200 calories.
What is that?
This is, am I allowed to say, a Reese's, okay? 200 calories. Now imagine you've got this full of candy.
Yeah.
Your child just eats five little things, just five things before he gets home. It's probably more than
Wait,
that.
Just a second.
1,000 calories right there.
David, are you suggesting that I pass out cough syrup to kids? Is that what you're saying to me?
You know, I love the fact that you noticed that. You see this artificial red dye that's in these things that you would never give your children if you were me? Guess what? It's in your children's multivitamins. It's in your children's cough syrup. Poison in the things that you're supposed to be helping your children with. We know to warn them about candy, but what about this? This is really an issue. Now, there are healthy snacks.
Hurry.
What's wrong with raisins? What's wrong with almonds?
Nothing.
What's wrong with pistachios?
No,
and even goldfish now are made without hydrogenated oil.
The only thing that we have a problem with is the clock, and now you've told us about all of this, so therefore this Halloween, trick-or-treaters get Pepto-Bismol at my house. This is Pat McMahon on the Morning Scramble.